Holly Heart Center, we have a comprehensive heart failure program that takes on the most challenging cases, offers access to cutting-edge technologies and medical interventions, and cares for patients with rare and complex diseases. Prior to considering an advanced heart failure intervention like an LVAD or transplant, there'll be long discussions on if there's any other opportunity to improve your heart failure. You'll be referred to the heart failure cardiologist by your home cardiologist. They will work together to sort out what the best treatment options are for you and if you warrant evaluation for an advanced heart failure intervention. They're going to meet a number of team members who are going to be educating them about transplantation, about their options, including heart pumps, if that's what they're interested in. They'll find this group to be supportive, to be empowering for the patient. I think they'll sense that the team is going to listen, and that's probably one of the most important characteristics is giving the patient and their family a chance to tell their story.
An LVAD or a VAD, you hear both of those terminologies interchange. The VAD, the VAD, is a ventricular assist device, so it does just that. It assists the heart, a sick heart that may not be able to adequately pump the blood to where your body needs. The pump itself is implanted into that heart surgically to now help that heart not have to work quite as hard in that pumping portion. And that pump continuously flows, allowing that blood flow to get to the essential organs and parts of the body for patients to live a quality life is the goal.
One of the transplant coordinators meet the patients when they are referred, describe and explain the process of evaluation, and get their consent to continue. So the evaluation involves medical testing. A heart transplant can be tough on the body, and we want to make sure that it is the right thing for the patient and that the patient is right for transplant. Additionally, the patient sees several members of the team beyond the coordinator. The cardiologist, the cardiac surgeon, our social worker meets with all of the patients.
I will identify what my role is with them and how I work with them ongoing. I will work with them on their social support, making sure it's appropriate and adequate to meet their needs, identifying any barriers throughout that evaluation. So if I can identify barriers, I'm able to work with them on making them the most successful patient they can. I also identify their strengths, and we can work upon those strengths to work with those barriers. I am available to them as often as they need. And when they go home with my phone numbers, they go home with my contact information, and I try to be as available to them as possible. It's a very unique, vulnerable population, and I just love the patients that I come in contact with. I'm their glorified cheerleader. I try to have as much fun with them as possible during this stressful time for both their families and the patient. So it's not just the patient I work with their entire system.
Patients are not all the same. So it's important for you to kind of treat patients on a case-to-case basis. In the pre-transplant phase, what we do is we meet with the patients, we review the medications that they're currently on and identify any potential issues that may interact or affect their post-transplant management. We identify if they have any issues, remember to take medications, or because we know that adherence is what's most important after transplantation. But we'll also incorporate our knowledge in other disciplines like cardiology or nephrology, management of kidney issues, or hepatology, management of liver issues. And it is important that we utilize our knowledge, our strong knowledge in medical management of these different disease states in helping to manage the patient after transplant.
The first time patients will encounter a clinical psychologist as part of the transplant evaluation is when we're looking at aspects of psychological functioning and their ability to manage with a transplant moving forwards. We found that people that take all their medications, that go to all their doctor's appointments, they actually have the highest level of success with transplant moving forwards. And so when people run into difficulties in those areas, oftentimes they'll get sent to the clinical psychologist, and I can help work with them to come up with a plan to help them really be successful. oftentimes people also feel very overwhelmed, and it can affect their moods, it can affect their behaviors, it can affect their relationships with loved ones. And in those settings, then talking with somebody like a psychologist is something that can help figure some of those issues out to help them be more successful also, and sort of having this whole team of people advance them through transplant.
Once patients enter the Advanced Heart Failure Program, they'll realize that it is a high touch, high communication, high advocacy group that's going to root for them, that's going to argue for them, that is going to try to find a way to offer them a therapy to get them to the next step.